Book of Matthew chapter 28 verses 1 to 10. Say Matthew chapter 28 verses 1 to 10. And it reads, "In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn towards the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. And the angel answered and said unto the woman, Fear not ye, for I know that ye seek Jesus which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said. Come see the place where the Lord lay. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead, and behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. And they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. Verse 9, and as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, All hail! And they came and beheld him by his feet and worshipped him. Verse 10, then said Jesus unto them, Be not afraid, go tell my brethren that they go into Galilee, and there shall they see me. Father and our friend, as we look into your word today, we pray, dear God, that you humble your manservant, forgive him where he would have sinned in word, thought, and deed, and make him fit to deliver this word on your behalf. Give your audience receptive hearts, dear God, as they receive this word. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. I want to share with us this morning, this Easter morning, 2018, on the topic, Jesus rose and lives in the hearts of every born-again believer. Jesus rose and lives in the heart of every born-again believer. I think that the craziest people on planet Earth are those people who do not believe that there is a God or some type of supreme being that brought this world into existence and keeps it going. While I have a very high level of respect for medical doctors, doctors of philosophy and scientists, I will forever continue to challenge them on the Big Bang. Scientists say the Big Bang theory is the leading explanation about how the universe began. At its simplest, it says the universe as we know it started with a small singularity, then inflated over the next 13.8 billion years to the cosmos that we know today. Scientists would want us to believe that some chemical particles came together over time and created our Earth. I do not in any way want to use this forum to bash everything our scientists and our doctors research, because honestly, they do a very, very good work to help our world. I just would never agree with them on the point where they deny that God or some type of supreme being created planet Earth. God created the sun, the moon, the stars, oxygen, and the sea. No scientist or mere man ever created those things or anything close to them. Every original thing that every scientist or every medical doctor uses in his or her field of work had its original creation from something God created. Having placed man on the earth through Adam and Eve, man became disobedient through the ages of the Old Testament as they continued to go further and further away from the one thing God told them not to do. Not to sin, and man continued to go further and further away from the one true and living God. This displeased God, and he decided to send the Savior of the world, who would teach and preach more love, more grace, more mercy, more forgiveness, and pay the penalty for sin once for all. That person was Jesus. God became flesh and dwelt among man. So says John chapter 1 and verse 14. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and the truth. Firstly, I want to share with us on point one. Jesus was rewarded on gratefulness for good. Jesus was rewarded on gratefulness for good. people 2,000 years ago were just as ungrateful as so many people even today. Many of the same people, just imagine this, many of the same people who followed Jesus, whether as faithful followers or out of curiosity, were the same people who joined with the jealous and grudge pastors and priests to bring him down. You think people clean? Those were the people who were worshipping him, following him, and who say, wow, look at these miracles. Some were faithfully following him, and some were following out of curiosity. Then the jealous scribes and Pharisees, they couldn't take it anymore. And they associated with the, and they called the people who were following Jesus to start associating with them. Be careful who you follow. Be careful who you listen to. Be careful who you associate with. Be very careful who you trust in life. Let's look at some of the good that Jesus did before he was betrayed. All Jesus did through his earthly ministry was good. And he was rewarded ungratefulness for good. Betrayed by one of the very members in his own church, you think people clean? Brother Judas. You think people clean? Be careful. There are a lot of Judases walking planet Earth today. Don't think they were just in Jesus' time. Be careful. They are deadly and dangerous, and they can destroy you if you don't be careful. Keep your eyes and ears on the lookout daily. Let's look at a few of the miracles, a little bit of the good that Jesus did. Touching his cloak. In the book of Matthew 9, verses 20 to 22. A woman who had been bleeding for 12 years came up behind Jesus. She couldn't take it anymore. She had tried doctor after doctor. She had tried physician. She had nurse after nurse. Probably plant healer. And she couldn't take it anymore. She had said to herself, I have been hearing a lot about this Jesus and how he had healed others and how he had performed other miracles. And if I could only touch his clothes, I will get well. Yeah. Jesus turned, having felt somebody touch his clothes, and the Bible tells us that virtue left his body. He turned in a massive crowd and he said, who touched me? His disciples and those around wanted to know, what kind of crazy man is this acting who touched me in a big crowd? But he had felt somebody with faith touch him. The lady, I assume, trembling. Jesus, it's me. An all-knowing God in the flesh. An all-knowing God in the flesh. He turns to the lady and says, lady, your faith has made you whole. I want to encourage us this morning here at the Good Tidings Gospel Hall. Have faith. No matter your situation in life, keep the faith. Faith in God can turn your situation around. Jesus was a curer of every disease. That's what got the scribes and the Pharisees jealous of him, because they didn't have the type of power that Jesus had. They were a bunch of hypocrites. Jesus went to every town and village. One story tells us in Matthew 9:35. He taught in meeting places and he preached the good news about God's kingdom and he healed every type of disease and sickness. We're not going to go to them this morning. This morning is a word to remind us about Jesus' resurrection. Remember the crippled man. In Mark 2 verses 9 to 12, it is easier for me to tell this crippled man that his sins are forgiven or tell him to get up and pick up his mat and go home. I will show you that the Son of Man has the right to forgive sins here on earth. They couldn't understand Jesus' power. How could this mere man, they thought, could be forgiven sins? But Jesus, my friend, was called by God, sent to earth by God to do what he was doing. When you're doing your ministry, whether it's preaching, whether it's singing, whether it's talking on the phone or using your WhatsApp for Jesus, do not worry about the haters. Do not worry about the hypocrites. You remember that your master Jesus, he was doing good and he was hated. So what if people hate you? You continue doing good. Jesus was rewarded on gratefulness for good. Remember the 10 lepers that healed. I tell you, long time people ungrateful. Luke 17 verses 12 to 16. Even before Brother Judas turned ungrateful, they were ungrateful people. 10 lepers came out. Jesus needs some help. He offers all of them healing. How many come back?
One.
You think is now people ungrateful?
No.
Let's look at the final miracle. The blind man at the pool of Siloam. John 9 verses 6 to 7. After Jesus said this is spit on the ground, he made some mud and smeared it on the man's eyes. Then he said, go wash off in the mud in the Siloam pool. The man went and washed in the pool. One who is said, that's what the pool meant. When he washed off, he could see. Never a man after Jesus walked earth with that kind of power. Never a man. That is why 2,000 years after, we are still talking about Jesus. People are still debating whether or not he existed. And that's why they're coming up with all kind of foolishness. But earth come from cosmos and all kind of foolishness. I respect the doctors. I respect the scientists. But until you confess that God is in charge of this world, God created the world, I would have no respect for you. Point number two. Haters and jealous people executed their plans on Jesus. Haters and jealous people executed their plans on Jesus. Let me tell you how ungrateful people are, Brother Martin. Prime Minister Pilate did not want to do Pastor Jesus anything, you know. He didn't want to do Pastor Jesus anything. I tell you, be careful who you associate with. Not a thing he wanted to do to him, but the people around. The people the Prime Minister kept around him or kept close to him wanted Jesus dead because they grudged, they got jealous, they're jealous. Be careful, I tell you. Be careful who you let around you and spend time with you. Be careful who you listen to in life. People can be dangerous and deadly, sister Alyssa. Don't be too trusting young people and older ones alike. People can set you up. It's Brother Judas who used to sing, glory, glory, hallelujah. Is he doing it?
Yes.
Sell out Pastor Jesus for 30 pieces of silver. You think people clean? Be careful. I learned the hard way certain things in my life. And I'm sure you can remember times in your life where people betray you. Be careful.
Yes.
Haters and jealous people execute their plans on Jesus. Matthew 27, 24 tells us that when the chief priests and the scribes, they hauled Jesus before Prime Minister Pilate or Judge Pilate. Pilate was the top man in Jesus' surrounding at the time. When Pilate saw he could prevail nothing, but that rather a tumult was made, Matthew 27, 24 tells us, he took water and he washed his hands in front of the people, saying, listen, I am innocent of the blood of this just person. To put it in today's term, may see nothing wrong with him. I examine him.
Yes.
I talk to him. This man is doing right.
Yes.
Could you imagine how unjust and unfair that court system was? No jury. The people set in their mind, having been convinced by the grudging scribes and Pharisees that we want Jesus dead. They go before the judge. He said, I ain't find a fault in him. The things people would do to save them. What? Because if they didn't do what the people wanted, their Pilate, you know what I'm going to do with Pilate? Because the Pilate is one man, you know.
Yes.
A man who had already committed murder.
Oh, yeah.
Standing here. And Jesus, who only did good, who only offered a word of encouragement, a word of hope to people, a man who only spoke out against wrong. You think people clean? They say, give us the murderer, let him come live with us.
Yes.
And kill that innocent man. You think people clean? They released Barabbas unto them, Matthew 27, 26. And when he had scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. And they stripped him and put on him a scarlet robe. Verse 29. And when they had plaited a crown of thorns, they put it on his head and a reed in his right hand. And they bowed the knee. knee before him and mocked him. This is Jesus, King of the Jews. Save yourself. They spat upon him. They gave him a crown of thorns. That is what they did to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But I'm happy that they weren't in charge. There was a bigger boss looking over. We call him our God and Master. And he was looking down. Man could do certain things in life, but they don't have all the power. Oh my, they could try. Matthew 27:35 tells us that they crucified him. They parted his garments, casting lots that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, that may parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture did they cast lots. Thirdly and finally, Jesus rose and lives in the heart of every born again believer. If our Jesus didn't rise, we wouldn't have a reason to be here this morning. If our Jesus didn't rise, we wouldn't have a reason to come every Sunday, to come every Wednesday, to come every Friday, whether at this church or my ministry or some other ministry around the world, we wouldn't have a reason to talk about Jesus. Oh my. I think it was Sisla who sang, "You can't keep a good man down." The grudge and jealous hating pastors and priests in Jesus' day thought that that was it when they set up the people to get Prime Minister Pilate to do something that he didn't want to do. They thought that was the end of Jesus. They laughed and they mocked and they pierced his hands and feet. They gave him a crown of thorns and they spat upon him. Just imagine somebody taking the spit from their mouth and they brushed their teeth. And they give you some of that in your face. Just imagine that. Oh my. This was the same Jesus, Brother Martin, that only went around doing good. When they were driving back the children, he said, "Suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven." This is the same Jesus who wasn't a greedy pastor. 5,000 plus people were following him. And he wasn't just talking about the kingdom of God. He told his members, "They got to be hungry. Who got something here to eat?" He grabbed a couple of loaves and fishes. He blessed it and he fed them. That is who they killed, Brother Liburn. An innocent man who was only doing good. You think people clean? Healing people. Helping people, reasoning with people, showing them mercy. They brought the adulterous woman before Jesus, and the law of Moses said, "Kill her, stone her to death." Jesus, a just judge, willing to offer mercy, grace, and forgiveness. He stoops down and he writes in the dirt, "He that is without sin, cast the first stone." In shame, they walk back. He turns to the adulterous woman and he says, "Woman, we are your accusers." He said, "Lord, nobody dear." Because all of them had sinned. All of us fail sometimes in life. Because we are Christians, because we are God followers, doesn't mean we are perfect. So never show your community members and your church and make them feel that we're perfect. God is still working on all of us, no matter how old you get. He told the adulterous woman, "Go and sin no more." Jesus rose and he lives in our hearts. During the process of persecuting Jesus as we close, God started to speak and the people got scared. You can play with people's mind, you know. This was the people in God in Jesus' day. They for him. They follow him and they love what they're doing. The scribes and the Pharisees put something in the head. They turn against him and they say, "Crucify him." And when they're done crucifying, they get scared. Darkness covered the earth. They saw me now. "What do we do?" You think you could go with people? They were sorry for what they had done. Matthew 27:45. Now from the sixth hour, there was darkness over the land until the ninth hour. Matthew 27:51. And behold, the veil of the temple was rent from top to bottom, and the earth did quake. Earthquake come. We
We do something wrong. We do something wrong. Matthew 27:53, and came and the 52, and the graves were opened, and many bodies of the saints that slept rose. What is going on here? They start to frighten. You think you could go with people? Be very careful you associate with. Stay under the right teaching of God, or people could mix up your mess up your head. Don't go on listening and joining. You listen this on radio, then you're gonna read this. Be careful who you listen to. Now when the centurion, Matthew 27:54 tells us, and they that were with him watching Jesus saw the earthquake and those things that were done, they feared greatly, the Bible said to me. I hear what the God will say now. Boy, truly, truly, this was the Son of God. Jesus rose. After doing good, after being killed for doing good, what he said would happen, happened. He said, destroy this temple, and in 3 days I'll build it up. 3 days after, Jesus rose. I'm not here to debate whether Easter is the real time that he died and whether it's 3 days from Friday to this. The fact is, Jesus Christ lived 2,000 years ago. He did good. The grudge and jealous scribes and Pharisees put something in the people's head to turn against Jesus. They crucified him. They killed him wrongfully. And 3 days after, he rose again. That's the basis of it. Don't let anybody tell you whether it ain't Easter, it ain't Christmas. That ain't their business. That's my business. Jesus was crucified. Bless God. And he rose again.
Yeah.
Stand to your feet.
Amen.
Friend. Jesus rose and lives in the heart of every born again believer. Listening to me all across the world, I want to challenge you right now to don't take God and his son Jesus Christ lightly. God sent Jesus into the world, listening here at the Good Tidings Gospel Hall and all across the world, to offer us a second chance because we had gone wrong. He could have just wiped out the entire world like he did with the flood, but he gave a chance by sending Jesus. Because our Jesus lives, we can face tomorrow. I challenge every Jesus follower around the world listening to me. Do not live in fear like the people of the world. Be bold for God. We should live and walk in confidence. Daily as true children of God. Many of the so-called gods that the people follow and they worship, none of them ever want them kind of miracles that our Jesus worked. When Jesus left, believers here at the Good Tidings Hall, Gospel Hall, and listening across the world, he said, I am leaving you with more power than I had, John 14:12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do. Because I go unto my Father. We cannot afford to be lukewarm Jesus followers. I challenge us that this Easter 2018, turn up the heat in your home, pray more, listen to more godly music, associate with more godly people, turn up your heat, turn up your boldness for God, turn up your confidence, and let us conquer this world for Jesus. I don't want to close this sermon today without giving you a chance to accept Jesus as Lord and Savior of your life. Whether here at the Good Tidings Gospel Hall or listening across the world, you're tired of the life that you're living. The drugs, the guns, the smoking, the alcohol, the multiple men or multiple women. You're tired of that life. You've been running for a long, long time. God says to you to come home.
Yeah.
Whether you're here at church, or you're listening to this on your Facebook, you're watching a replay of this on YouTube, I challenge you to put God first. Make Jesus your choice today. Walk away from the bad company. Walk away from the so-called friend. Remember Judas. If you continue to stay around the wrong crowd, you're going to be betrayed and get hurt. Turn around and put your trust in God. With every head bowed and eyes closed, lift your hands, let's pray. Father, we thank you today for the spoken word, reminding us of your death, burial, and resurrection. And reminding us, dear God, that your son Jesus left us hope. We thank you, dear God, that you are all powerful, you are all knowing, and you are all true. And we thank you for sending your son Jesus Christ to teach us how to love more. Love more. Love more. At this Easter 2018 service, we ask, dear God, to give us a fresh boldness, a fresh confidence, rejuvenate us, and may, dear God, others look on and see that there is revival in the church, and things will never be the same again across the world because we're putting Jesus first. And with Jesus in the picture, we will revolutionize the world. In Jesus' name, amen. Clap your hands for Jesus.